Hi everyone, this is Terry. Today I want to talk to you about the accessories that came with your machine and how to use them for sewing. One of the things you find is the all-purpose wide opening stitch plate that came with your machine. I call this a zigzag plate, but this plate is one that you're going to use for just about everything. This stitch plate can be used for your utility stitches, your decorative stitches, and even embroidery. You'll see that it has etchings across the front. Those etchings are marked from 1 inch to the left and then from 0 to 2 inches in the front. Those are aligned with the center needle position. On the back, you'll notice etchings that are marked also. And again, those etchings are marked with the left needle position. So you'll see that it's shifted. The 0, if you take it and line it up, will be 1/8 of an inch to the left. You usually are going to use your J foot for most of your utility stitches, and that has markings as well. The J foot has a marking on the left needle position, the center needle position, and it is also has markings on the right needle position. The bottom of this foot is flat, so you don't see anything that is cut out. That's why when you go to the decorative stitches, you will be asked to change to your end foot. It's important that you do that because the end foot has an opening in the back. You can see it's carved out so that you can use it for those decorative stitches that need to feed through the center of this foot. The other thing that you'll see that you have is the W foot. Now the W foot is a foot that you use for your embroidery. You can also use the plug-in foot that's an optional foot that came with the Dream Machine. It's not necessary to have that foot. It has a plug-in because of the laser light. With a camera that is built into the luminaire, the projector, and so many things, this foot works well. Now, one of the things with the feet, and let me remove it. Most feet, you have a shank that's like this, and these are for the snap-on feet. So they snap on like this, and you'll see that this is where your screw goes in on the side of the machine. When you're using your W foot, you'll need to take this off of your machine to put your W foot on the machine. In most instances, you're going to be using the snap-on feet on your machine, or you'll be using your embroidery foot and using this screw to attach it. But there are going to be times that you will be using feet that require what is called the S adapter, and I'll show you that. Let me move this out of the way, and now let's look at the S adapter. The S adapter is a metal piece that is stamped with the S. You can see it right here. And what you do is you take the screw that's in the back of with your machine and you line up the hole and you screw this into the foot that requires the S adapter. This is to raise this foot, which can be also used on a low shank machine to make it a high shank foot. Our machines are what it's called a high shank machine. There are several feet that you will buy that are optional feet that require the use of the S adapter. Now to get this on your machine, you'll see that it has this opening here. You'll need to take the needle bar and place this over the needle bar, and then you'll use the screw to screw this inside on the needle bar. Now to get this on, what I recommend that you do is you raise the presser foot in the back. You need to hold it up with your hand so that it raises to the highest level. Line it up, and when you line it up, this foot will slide right on, and then all you have to do is screw it in place. I won't do that because I think you understand the mechanics of it. Now we're going to talk about the straight stitch plate. Turn your machine off to put this plate on, and when you turn it on, you'll see that this stitch plate has several things that are ideal for straight stitching. You'll want to use straight stitch feet that came with your machine. You can use what is called the straight stitch foot. You can use the quilting foot with a guide, and then you can also use optional feet. For instance, this is what is called a 1/4 inch foot. And I'll tell you which one I like and which and why. The straight stitch foot that came with your machine has three markings on the toe. On the inside, you have a marking that is 1/8 of an inch. The center marking is 3/16. The third marking on the toe represents 1/4 inch, and the outside is 5/16. In millimeters, those are 2.25, 4.25, 6.25, and 8.5 millimeters. So if you're using this particular foot, sometimes it doesn't snap into place, just lift it up. And let's say that what we're doing is we're using it for quilting. We're going to use this line that's on the front of the plate along with the line right here. And you will see that I need to use this mark, which is the third toe or mark on the foot, not the third toe. But you need to follow it, not the edge of the foot. That's why this is not my preference for using for piecing. Now, if I was going to use this for sewing garments and I had a 5/8 inch seam, this is great because I'm going to follow the markings that are on my stitch plate along with the lines on the bobbin cover. We'll go ahead and remove this foot. We'll raise it, push the button on the back, and remove it. Now we'll look at the foot that has the guideline. I just typically take my feet and tilt them by the toe, but because this one has that guideline, what I'm going to do is just snap it into place. Now you notice that this is definitely lined up with a 1/4 inch line. It has a metal piece, which really is nice for some piecing. But if you have something with angles, then this may get in the way, or if you're going over seams. So you can see my fabric is lined up against this, and it's at 1/4 inch, and I had that center needle position. We'll look at the next foot. This did not come with the machine. It's an optional foot, and it's very inexpensive. So you can look for it on the internet, or you can look for it at your dealer. Now, the thing I like about this foot is the edge of this foot. And actually, let me move it along so you can see. The edge of this foot is 1/4 inch. This toe on the inside is 1/8 inch. And there are markings along this foot that give me 1/4 inch. This is aligned with the needle. This would be aligned at the back of the fabric edge, and then you also have a marking on the front, and likewise you have markings for 1/8 inch. If you look at in comparison this foot, it has the 1/8 inch markings as well, and it has the 1/8 inch toe, but it doesn't have the same markings that are the 1/4 inch. So my favorite foot for piecing is this optional foot. And again, this foot is called 1/4 inch quilting foot. And you can locate that foot from your dealer. So whenever you have your straight stitch plate on, one of the things that you'll see is you cannot select a stitch like a zigzag stitch. It'll tell you to turn the machine off and remove the plate, and you'll replace it with your wide opening plate. We'll choose return, and I'll show you something else. So if I tried to choose a needle position, such as a middle needle position, it's fine. If I try to choose a left needle position or a right needle position, you'll notice the needle does not shift. And that's because I had the straight stitch plate on my machine. I hope all of this information helps you. And in our next videos, I'll show you how to use the guide beam. Thanks, and have a great day.